she wins. People bear witness. Thank you for letting us be ourselves.
Chuck D here, along with the King of Rock, Mr. D.M.C. We are on the real, off the record here for Real News Network. And really, President Barack Obama has taken office to be the president of the United States for the next 4 years. People call it the highest position in the world. When he talked about, you know, everybody coming and paying attention, we've heard from everybody. But when he talked musically, right, you know, the names that stood out, people like Bruce Springsteen,
the usual.
U2, Bono makes it, you know, a conversation about, you know, help Palestine. Mm-hmm. You know, these people in rock, the legends in rock and roll and other forms of music, have a front and center stage of boldness and braveness to talk about, and also be anointed, like, and respected for who they are.
Right, and the rappers are punks.
Rap music gets no respect because they say, well, rappers really ain't saying anything. And the week before, Run DMC is inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. What is this missing link, and even black media or media from connecting the two to the point where, I mean, a DMC and a Run could have been there, you know, invited to be along with the celebration. What is this missing link, man, that's not anointing the heroes such as yourself and being revered just as much as the Bruce Springsteen and the Bono, who sure enough know the accomplishments of Run DMC?
That's weird, because when the election started and Obama was running his campaign and everybody knew he was going to win, all the press people from all over the ages hit Tracy Miller, our publicist, and said, I'm talking about journalists. This is happening. Obama was only made possible because of what Run DMC did with hip hop when they did it. So that's a big, don't say that. Don't say that. And as I was, last couple of months, people kept saying it. They kept saying it. But it's weird, because if you look at those rock and roll dudes, see, maybe it's because the hip hop of the last 20 years ain't saying nothing. We don't want those guys here because they're going to do this, or we can only expect this from them. But if you look at John Lennon, if you look at Bob Dylan, if you look at Fogerty, if you look at any of those rock and roll guys, whether it was in the 60s, Vietnam War, they didn't care what people thought about it. They wrote about what was going on in their communities. Mm-hmm. We are the voices of those people. It's a shame that Run DMC, Chuck D, KRS-One, Paris, we can only get on the radio, old school at noon, 12 o'clock to 1 o'clock in the day. Where are all the kids at in school?
Right.
But from 3 o'clock to 6 o'clock, what do you hear? Maybe there's a conspiracy. I don't believe in conspiracy theories, but maybe it's because, like I said in the first segment, we let the value of what hip-hop meant to the world, to the streets, to the generations, deteriorate because of those elements who really don't care about the real purpose of our culture and our art form. You know, it's a shame that hip-hop doesn't have the Bruce Springsteens and Dylans. We've been saying this already.
2 million plus people in jail, and there's a disproportionate amount of black males. Right. Now, I'm going to narrow this down to the black male demographic for a second. In all those cities that were played by the KRS-Ones, the Tribe Called Quest, the Eric B. Rakims, the Run DMCs, from the Columbus, Ohio's, to the Wichita, Kansas, to the Sacramento, California's, to the Florida's, they're the black men who are 25 to 50 who are part of the hip-hop nation.
Right.
BET or TV1, all these stations are out there. Who talks to these people? Let's break it down to the men. Right. Who talks to those men? Because, you know, Oprah might talk to women, and there's a demographic of black women that might listen to, you know, they check out Essence or to a segment of the radio,
right?
You know, because, you know, this type of entertainer comes through. Patti LaBelle still has a voice that's out there, and people like
they listen to the Michael Bateson's.
To that cat that sits down, you know, and the cat might sit and listen to Michael Bateson.
Right, because it's the closest he could get.
Closest that they can get to, you know, because, you know, you know, a white cat who is like, let's say, 55 years old, somebody in the age range of Steve Jobs.
Right.
Is going to look across and say, you know, all right, you know, Steven Tyler. Yeah, I can relate.
I can relate, for sure.
And, you know, whatever he says.
Bono, it's always
the respect thing. What does the 37-year-old black dude, you know, he's been working, he might have got laid off from the car plant, You know, he's trying to come up. He, you know, a couple of his kids like in the 1920 zone or whatever.
Right.
Who talks to him? And at the same time, you know, there's a 23 or 24-year-old cat coming up now who's got a different mentality than the one.
Who wants to listen to what this guy had to, right.
Who talks to these people?
It's not like we don't exist. We exist, and we probably have a majority too, but there's no outlets for us to be heard. There's no outlets for dialogue. There's no outlets for the music unless we do it ourselves. There's a lot of us who've been, we've been doing this,
mm-hmm.
but we're not being allowed to be heard. It's like I always said, you know, I could go say this to the new generation. I could go tell the Jeezys and the Lil Waynes, you know, do what you do, but you need to be doing this. And people say they don't need to do nothing. I mean, from a hip hop standpoint, they really need to be doing it, but they're not going to listen to me. You know what I'm saying? So there's no outlets for us. I want that. I'm coming home from work. I don't want to hit a radio. But where is that? The topics of, you know, what Run DMC, PE, even Will Smith, that generation, there's nothing for us. Who talks to us? There's a lot of people that want to be talked. There's a lot of people that want to talk about these issues, but there's no outlet for us. That's why we're sitting here trying to do this.
What happens when the financial picture changes, when all of a sudden, you know, people used to sell like these umpteen amount of records and all of a sudden it meant residuals. Now all of a sudden they say that the record business is totally flipped upside down. People are not selling records. You know, what does a artist who's been who might have a 10-year career and all of a sudden they used to sell records, now they don't sell records, what does that artist do at this point? I mean, can management come in like the Calvary and save the day?
You can't fix it. You can't, like a lot of those executives that lived during that era, they're over. They had their ride. A lot of those artists are just rappers with a lot of money. Like, I had...
Money disappears if you don't actually make it cycle.
Oh, for sure. No, they're trying to worry about it now. They're like, man, I made a mistake for buying those three houses. Made a mistake for having that yacht, because when it's sitting there, you got to pay for that. Mm-hmm. Now, I have lawyers and managers and even a couple of executives who just got in the game saying, yo, playtime is over. That whole era is over. But there's a difference. You know, a couple of journalists will say, a lot of the rappers in the last 10 years are just rich celebrities. Like, it started bugging me out when, wow, rap is getting looked at by the tabloids. Mm-hmm. And rap is being looked at like the gossip, you know, by the gossip industry and stuff like that. But there was a time where, you know, when you see Chuck or you see, oh, let's say that you see Big Daddy Kane or you see Guru or you see, you know, you see a Freddie Fox, people stop and go, wow. Yo, man, you don't know what your music did to me. But now it's like, wow, he's dating such and such. Whoa, he got a lot of money. They don't even talk about life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even the gangster rapper would make a record. You know, people talk about who's really street and who's really gangster, who has the essence. They forget about Scarface. Right. Mom playing tricks on you. I don't like none of the rap, the gangsters, and I'm pushing this, and I'm the big man, and I'm the boss, and all that. That's all. That don't get my attention. But when I hear Scarface say, I'm alone in a room standing, at night I can't sleep, I toss and turn, that's gangster to me, because he's talking from the perspective of our lives. I don't need to hear how many drugs you sold, how many people you killed, because I could pick up USA Today and see that. I could pick up the Daily News and see 60 notes shooting like that. But it was inspiring to hear the people from the community, those three or four elements, meaning on every neighborhood, whether it's Beverly Hills or wherever it's the ghetto, there's Chino, Dino, and Nino, who you know going to go to jail just like their father before them. But there's also Richard, who you know he's going to go to Harvard. There's also John. Oh, he's going to be the next Dwayne Wade. There's that rapper guy. But then there's also the regular guy that's just going to drive the bus for 50 years, get his pension, and live a creative life. Those issues, ideas, and concepts is what separated hip-hop from everything else. But it was also brother and sister, just like I said. The Beatles were big pop successes, but when they got to the point where they knew they had power, look what John Lennon did.
Right.
Look at what Dylan did. You know what I'm saying? So who's speaking for these people? There's a lot of voices for these people, but now it's time for these voices to be heard. The Obama isn't new.
Right.
You know, I tell people, yo, we can celebrate Obama all we want, but he ain't no babysitter.
Right.
And the guys in the hood look at me like, Riff, what do you mean by that? Just because he there doesn't mean these conditions is going to change. But rap music was able to change those conditions. You know, it wasn't just like, I tell the young kids, I wasn't just spitting a 16 and impress my 16-year-old friend.
Right.
We had legislators, lawmakers, journalists, writers, and politicians, and psychologists going, do you hear what these young people in this neighborhood with nothing did? It wasn't just about how much money they was making. They would always look at us and say, do you see and hear what we are saying and doing? That's what's missing. The problem is this generation. You know, it's a waste of time for me to go try to tell 50 and Ja Rule make up friends right. and stuff like right. that. For them to have change, they're going to, I needed my pair. Listen, I was D.M.C., even I'm the king of rock.
Right.
Positive rap here and there. But I was running around drinking and smoking. But when I looked to the left, I had P.E. saying that. I looked to the right, I had KRS saying that. I looked to the back, I got Rakim over there. I got EPMD over there. We had the whole circumference of the existence we were living being discussed through our music. That's not happening right now. So maybe they got to think twice. Okay, we'll bring these guys here, but we ain't going to let them say anything. I did a party on the 18th for the inauguration. It was me, Ludacris, and Nelly was hosting it.
Mm-hmm.
I went in there, did like 7 records, a couple of new records, and left. And all those people who had never seen Run DMC live came to me and said, yo, that was the best performance I ever seen. And all I did was this tricky. I went out there. I said, yo, we're going to take a page from how the Zulu Nation used to do it before rap records was on records. You know, the P, they right. drunk or whatever, but they're looking like this. And I was like, remember when Bam said, Busy B said, what's the name in this nation? Now who's going to get out? I said, what's the name? I had to teach him. I said, what's the name of our president? Barack, now tell me who's in the White House. Obama, Obama, keep going, y'all. What's the name of my president? And these people were like amazed. You know what I'm saying? Even though what we do right. is new, and it's old to
they
us.
They shouldn't have been amazed.
And, right.
And at the same time.
Right.
But we'll be back with the King of Rock from the Beatles of Rap, Run DMC, when we return on the Real Off the Record. And check out this next segment, so you better stay tuned.